like to record the message today about the voice of God. And this will be a continuation of videos which I made some months ago. They are called The Voice of God and How to Communicate with God through Language of Understanding. I'm not gonna repeat those messages again. To understand this message, you have to watch the first two videos. This will be an addition to those videos. So to cut the story short and to make a brief introduction, I was in the teaching and preaching the teaching that Jesus leads everybody daily through you hearing His voice literally into your spirit, Him saying words to you. And I believe that was the right way, as many Christians believe, as Pentecostal church teaches. But in 2015 I had a miracle after I was chastised for many months with God's chastisement for not helping the poor like He ordered me to do. Jesus Christ visited me. He came and He stopped the chastisement. And He showed me marvelous things. He showed me hell. He showed me I was on the way to hell. And one of the things He told me was that this teaching that you have to literally hear His voice every day to be led by His Spirit is not of Him. And it causes a lot of unsobriety in the body of Christ. Unsobriety is when people are in the beginning of deception, when they think higher of themselves. The reason for that is high opinion, because Jesus Christ, He also told me that He speaks through language of understanding. That's His voice. That's how He leads people daily. As the Old Testament prophets heard the voice of God literally speak to them like Moses, what Jesus also explained to me, those people had great gift of humility, because I'm expanding on what He explained. They had years behind them of works for humility, for the gift of humility, like fasting, like vigils, like prayers on the knees. So through years and even decades of training themselves in humility, God was able to speak to them with His voice, like with Moses. And as far as I understand, even to them, He didn't speak every day with His voice. So this teaching about that this is how you should be led by Jesus Christ, by hearing His voice daily, is not of God. So they just stopped trying in their efforts to try to hear the voice of Jesus Christ daily, to be led by Him. Because this is not only wrong, but this is super dangerous. And let me show you why. After Jesus taught me, and after He taught me His language of understanding, some time passed, and I thought, well, I want to try to hear God's voice again, like He spoke to me literally, like I thought He spoke to me literally before, like all those years when I followed Him, that was before 2015. And I asked Jesus to speak to me with His voice, like before, and He led me to try to do it, but to check it with the language of understanding, through doing self-reproving, how He taught me, through doing prayer standing, and through language of understanding to check that voice which I was hearing. And I laid prostrate on the floor, and I know that what I'm gonna say now will shock many people, but it is good for your sobriety. It's good so you wake up. It's good so you stop those efforts. So what I did was this. I laid prostrate on the floor and I cried out to Jesus to please speak to me. And the voice started speaking to me, the voice which looked like Jesus. And frankly to me, if I didn't know the language of understanding, I would believe it's Jesus. And then I stood up and went, did self-reproving, did prayer standing, and asked Jesus to confirm me if it was Him. And through the language of understanding, Jesus didn't confirm this voice to me. And I went again on the floor and prayed again for Jesus Christ to speak to me. Again the voice spoke to me. And I stood up in prayer standing, did self-reproving, and asked Jesus Christ to confirm through language of understanding if it was Him. And again, it wasn't Him. And I made it like this maybe, I don't know, 7, 10 times, maybe more than 10, I do not remember, but a lot of times like this. I was going to the floor, going up, and asking Jesus to confirm it to me. And all the times He disconfirmed it to me, that it was not Him. And I became in terror. Sometimes the voices were a little bit different, and I thought, well, maybe this is now Jesus. Now He will confirm it to me. And He disconfirmed all those voices, all of them. I was terrified. What's wrong with me? What's wrong with other Christians who believe this teaching? And I started to ask Jesus through language of understanding to explain to me what's going on and to lead me in the safest way as possible. This is what really happens, is demons, they can see what God writes on your heart through language of understanding, because they have to tempt you not to do that which God put in your heart to do, wrote on your heart to do. They will see your thoughts, your memories, because they won't be able to test you with images from your memory, with knowing what you think to write that you sinned or not sinned somewhere. So they know your thoughts, your memory. They know what God writes on your heart through language of understanding. So they can tempt you not to do which God wrote you to do there, or to do that which He forbids you to do through language of understanding. So basically what happens is this, that they read to you with their voice, which looks like Jesus' voice, that which Jesus Christ writes to you on your heart through language of understanding. And why they do it is to puff you up, and also to get you into their will. For example, how it worked with me and with other people, I guess, is this, that God wrote on your heart one day to go and preach the gospel. And you ask, seek Jesus, what to do. And demons with a voice which looks like Jesus' voice see that it's written on your heart, go preach the gospel. And they say to you, go preach the gospel. And you think, what I heard matches with that which is written on my heart. It must be Jesus. And you go preach the gospel, and you see the hand of God there. You see that God does something there. He saves some people, or something supernatural happens. And you are sure that God is leading you through His voice now, like Moses, because you heard the voice, you went, you did, and you saw the hand of God, it worked out. And you subconsciously get puffed up with pride that you must be on a higher level, like prophets in the Bible. You know, that God leads you with His voice every day. And what happens is that you get used to hearing the voice which reads to you from the heart. You know what God puts you to do. Sometimes the voices speak lies. Some voice might confirm to it. Some voice might just read the right thing which is written on your heart to confuse you, to mix you up. And then when you got used to listening to the right voice which you think, which is actually also demons, which sound like Jesus who read to you from the language of understanding on your heart, one day that voice tells you to do something contrary to that which Jesus wrote you on your heart. For example, Jesus shows you something on your heart to do something, and the voice says, no, don't do it. Like you got to trust the voice, you know. And people trust the voice, and the person gets into the will of demons in some area, you know. And that's how it happens. And also his pride grows up, and the more the pride grows up, the more deceptions God allows demon to deceive this person, because those who love pride love lies. Pride is lies. Pride is you bigger than you really are, and you're really nothing, you know. And pride is, you know, believing in lies and loving lies, and those who love pride love lies, and they deserve to be deceived and mocked by demons, you know. So that's why I preach on humility so much, because I got terrified what's happening, you know. And I understood why Jesus showed me that this teaching leads to such unsobriety, you know, with voices. And I hope it helps you too. Oh, some people might wonder why Jesus, you know, revealed it to me and didn't reveal it to other people. Well, that's because before Jesus came to me, I was in great chastisement for alms, for sin with alms, and I thought I'm going to hell. And my pride went away because I was under chastisement for 11 months. And I wasn't thinking anymore that I'm spiritually rich or that I'm, you know, rich in heaven. And I thought I'm going to hell, I'm chastised, how to stop it? You know, and after 11 months like that, God humbled my high opinion of myself and He showed me the truth. Jesus Christ might speak with His voice from time to time to people, literal voice. But that's not how He leads people every day and often. Because hearing His voice is a very high-level Christianity like prophets of Old Testament. And even those teachings in the Bible where Paul says about church that when they come together, the prophets, you know, they prophesy. Prophecy is not always hearing the voice of God. It's speaking under the influence of Holy Spirit, what Holy Spirit puts on your heart to speak. You do not have to be like a prophet, like an Old Testament, to do that. But just being influenced by Holy Spirit to speak something. That, I think, all Christians can do, maybe not always, but from time to time. You know, but that's one meaning of prophecy. But another prophecy is like speaking future or hearing God's voice about future or about some events and speaking it to other people. People who usually did that were elders or people who followed God for decades with works for humility. And even those prophets who were young, like David, you know, who were not old, and other young prophets, God kept them from birth from sinning. They did not live in iniquity like we lived before repentance, you know. They were Jews. They were raised in commandments of God from childhood, and they were kept by God like special vessels, and they accumulated, even when they were maybe 30 years old, they already accumulated great gift of humility, because they were fasting from early age, you know, and they were kept by God, you know, like Mary, Jesus' mother, like John the Baptist, David, King David, you know. We lived in iniquity before repentance, therefore we are not big in the kingdom of God, you know. The Satan puffs us up that we are big. We are not big at all. I maybe will make some video later about understanding our measure in Christ, that it's much more modest than many people expect, you know, because the devil deceives people that when you do good things, you get filled with Holy Spirit, you know, and it cleanses all your past passions for all the life which you were not following Jesus. The reality is much more modest. You do get cleansed, but not in a too big measure. It takes a lifetime of good works, of fasts, of preaching, you know, to only clean your heart, not to mention to clean your body. You know, the people who live in the wilderness, they manage to not only clean their heart, but even their body from the passions which they put in when they were not following Jesus Christ. To me, when Jesus visited me, He said to forget about cleansing the body. You know, I'm not sinning, those who willfully sin go to hell, they're on the way to hell. But the life which I lived before coming to Christ, you know, it pollutes not only your soul with passions, but even your body. People who live in the wilderness, by old age, some of them manage to totally cleanse their soul and totally cleanse their body from evil passions, you know. And us, if we manage to cleanse even the soul to some extent, you know, God may have mercy on us and save us into His kingdom. You know, but I'm saying it so you do not think that we're big in Christ. So that's how it is, and as for me, I ask God to lead me by the safest method, you know, possible. And since 2017, God never speaks to me with His voice, literally. He only leads me through language of understanding. And I am very happy about this method. it works very good comparing to the method before which I tried, because that method is basically the same language of understanding, plus demons read it to you and deceive you often, you know. So this is the core of God's guidance. This is how He really guides most people, you know. And I'm more than happy with this method. It only doesn't work when you're in pride. If you're in pride, if you're in high opinion of yourself, the devil can deceive you even through this method also. But compared to all other methods in Christianity, this is the ultimate, very best, safest method ever possible. That was which apostles preached. That's the voice of God. That's what early church fathers preached, was the voice of God. That's His will, movement of His will, that you understand what God wants you to do now. He puts it on your heart. He writes His laws on your heart. He gives you the mind of Christ, that you understand what is right to do now. And you do self-reproving and seek Jesus Christ, and He confirms it to you through self-reproving, through your understanding, all the revelations, all the guidance, and it doesn't pop you up as much, because God doesn't speak to you with His voice. You understand that you are little in His kingdom. And this is the truth. May Jesus bless you.